If there's no resurrection, we're still bound. We're still under the influence of the devil. If there's no resurrection, because, amen, everything hangs on the fact, not that Jesus died, but on the fact that he got up. Amen. Everything is resting on that. So if he did not get up, amen, he did not conquer death. He did not conquer hell. Hell and death, amen, in the power of Satan still has dominion and is still reigning because Christ could not get up. But, and understand, the Bible tells us that Satan did everything that he could to hold him. Peter talks about it and said it was not possible for death to hold him. Amen. That tells us that death tried to hold him. Death tried to keep him in captivity. Death tried to keep him from rising from the dead. They even made preparations on the earth that when he died and they put the body in the tomb, that they placed soldiers before the tomb. Amen. Thank God to guard the tomb to make sure that Jesus didn't get out.
Praise God.
Yeah. So go there, amen, and set guards and put the soldiers before it, and they are there watching the body. They did not know that the spirit was already someplace else working. Amen. Thank God they did not know that. So they're standing watch over the grave, and amen. Thank God. And so after the angel was dismissed from heaven and came down in Matthew's gospel and sit on the rock, amen. Thank God. And the women came down wondering who was going to move the stone. Amen. Thank God. When they got there and looking at the tomb, the angel said to them that, amen, said, I know who you're looking for. Amen. You seek Jesus. Amen. But I want you to know he's not here. He has risen as he said. He's gotten up just like he said he would. Amen. Thank God. So he's the resurrection. So after they moved the stone so that the women could get in, not so Jesus could get out, but so that the women could get in. And I, you know, and understanding, amen, he being in, buried in the Mount of Olives in the grave of Joseph in the tomb. Amen. If you ever been to Israel and gone through the Mount of Olives and gone to the tomb, you will find out that, amen, that in that graveyard, that tomb had two sections, amen, a first entrance and a second entrance, amen, and that was a slab that was stretched out that Jesus was placed on. And so when they entered in, thank God, they did not go into the second part of the opening, they only went into the first. And when they went into the first, they saw there an angel at the head of Jesus and one at the foot of his body. Amen. Is what they viewed when they went to the tomb and looked in. Amen. But Jesus was already gone. Amen. So now the Bible says to us that he tells the disciples when they come to go tell, amen, the rest of the disciples that he had risen from the dead. So the argument continues where he said, we are found as false witnesses. Thank God that we are teaching something that is not true. We're preaching a gospel that has no power. So he says, if we have hope in this life only, then we are of all men most miserable. Thank God for believing in the resurrection. It is so important to us because if you remember, amen, when Philip met the eunuch, the question that was asked the eunuch, if thou believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God or that God has raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. The eunuch reply was, I believe that Jesus, amen, is the Son of God. Amen. I accept that. And immediately they went down in the water. The eunuch baptized. Philip baptized the eunuch and went on his way. But there was no, amen, baptism until after the eunuch confessed that he believed that Jesus Christ was the divine Son of God. Amen. And on that confession, hallelujah, he entered into a relationship with the Lord. Amen. On that day. And so, amen, the argument continues as we look back at what Paul is saying here. Paul is the apostle that was born out of time. He's the one, amen, that was not among the 12. He was not with the 70. He was born years later, amen, thank God, rather into the family of God later, amen, but he was not there when the apostles was called. Therefore, amen, he said, I was one born out of time, but I got special revelation of the resurrection. I know how it works. I know how important it is. I know how it comes to pass. Amen. So that we might understand that there is life after death. Amen. That there is hope. after the hope has passed in this world. Amen. That all of our hope is not focused upon this life, because there is a life thereafter. The Bible tells us that if we be dead with Christ, then we shall also reign with him. All of this is speaking to us not only of hope in this life, but of hope in the life to come. And so he says to us that you need to focus your faith and your power on the power of God. What God is able to do. You're wondering about the resurrection of your physical bodies, but just look at the power of God. Amen. The power of God that raised Jesus up from the dead will also quicken and raise your mortal body. The power that is in Christ is there. Amen. Thank God, not only so that we live in this life, but it connects us with the life to come. We are identified with him through death. We are raised with him through resurrection. Amen. The Bible says that, amen, when he got up, amen, all of us got up with him. That's every believer got up with him. And every believer, amen, is seated at the right hand of God. We are seated with him in heavenly places. Listen, children of God, God has already predestined and arranged that we are already seated with him in heaven, which means in the mind of God, it's already done. Amen. He see us in Christ. All of us who coming in and all of those who have entered in, he see us as sitting together in heavenly places with the Lord Jesus Christ. When Jesus got up, amen, now every person that acknowledged him got up with him. He's not working to save us now. He wants us to connect with the plan that's already made. Yeah, amen. He wants us to connect with that plan. He wants us to become part of that plan that is already provided for us. Thank God we don't have to go out and start another doctrine. We don't need another gospel. We need to believe the gospel that's already preached. We need to believe that which Jesus has already spoken, that he left heaven and came to earth, that he died for our sins, rose again for our justification, and is put back into glory where now he is our intercessor. Amen. He's making intercessions for us as high priest in the heaven. Amen. But he had to go through the tomb, through the grave, in order to get to the place where that he could raise us up. Amen. So I thank God today that, amen, we are risen with him. In this identification, the Bible tells us in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, amen, he tells us, amen, that we have a spiritual connection. That by the Spirit we are joined to him. We are joined with Christ by one Spirit. So if I'm joined with him, just like he got up, amen, because I'm joined with him, I'm going to get up. Because so he said there's no scientific facts, according to the Corinthians, that a body can be raised from the dead. There's no scientific fact that a body, amen, can go in the tomb and stay in the tomb or in the grave for 15, 20, 30, 40, 50 years, and then God raised and put that body back together and caused it to come forth. They said that's an unscientific thing. It cannot be done. It can't be proven. So Paul is proving the fact, amen, that God can raise the dead. That it doesn't matter about how long the body has been sleeping in the grave, that Jesus, amen, still have power to raise the dead. Oh yeah, he can put the left foot back on, but he can put the right arm back on. Amen. It doesn't matter about how you died. It doesn't matter about if you were killed in a car wreck. Amen. Thank God if you were shot dead, however you died, whatever part was missing. Amen. When you died, when you rise again, there's not going to be any missing members. You're going to have all your members, all of your legs, your toes, your eyes. Everything is going to be restored. Amen. Ain't going to be no one-armed saints in heaven. No one-legged saints in heaven. Ain't going to be none there. Amen. Thank God, because he's going, amen, to resurrect, restore, renew, and put us all back together again. Yeah. Thank you, Lord. Thank God for the resurrection. Amen. Thank God for the resurrection. It was said some time ago that, amen, you know, and I think sometimes it still happened that that people who, amen, request to be cremated, many of them who are not saved, amen, are trying to escape just in case there's a place called hell. Amen. But I want you to understand today, whoever approach you with that idea, let them know today that it doesn't matter about where your ashes are. You can get up in an airplane and spread them all across the universe. But when God calls you, amen, all them ashes gonna come together. Thank God, they gonna come right back together, and God's gonna take that same spirit and put back in that body. Thank God, there's nothing gonna be missing. Understand what I'm saying? So that, amen, burning it up, amen, drowning it in the sea, leaving it at the bottom of the sea, it doesn't matter. When God raised you up, thank God, that's what's going to happen to us. Let me close out. Amen. Now, in the end of this argument, Paul says, behold, I show you a mystery. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we shall not all sleep, but we all shall be changed in the moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump. For the trump shall sound, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Amen. Thank God. This mortal, amen, is going to put on immortality. Thank God. Thank God. Amen. Death is going to be swallowed up. Amen. The kingdom is going to be offered up to the Father. All of this is what's going to take place. Amen. He said, those of us who are living, amen, we'll be changed. It's going to happen before you can even wink your eye. Glory to God. It's going to happen before we can wink our eyes. So, amen. He said, this is the mystery. How quick we're going to change. This is an awesome God. God can change the structure in the molecular parts of your body and shape it. Amen. Thank God. Amen. So that this body now can live eternally. Thank God. This body won't see natural death. This body, amen, will be changed into a body like unto his own glorious body. And I tell you today, that's what I'm looking for. I'm waiting for the day when he called me. Amen. Because the body that you will receive then will be a body that is free from pain. It'll be a body that knows nothing about sicknesses and diseases. It's a body that doesn't require maintenance because it is a body like his own body. Thank God. So he said this is what the believer has to look forward to. But when I read, amen, in the word concerning the resurrection, I read where the Bible declares that Jesus, when he got up from the grave, that he had all power in his hands. Amen. The power of life and death was given unto him. Thank God. So he rose saying, all power is in my hand. Thank God. I have the keys. I got the keys of death and hell. Amen. They belong to me. And so in this powerful structure of resurrection, the Bible declares that when he left out of the grave, because grave could not hold him, thank God, he said, grave, where is your victory? And he asked death, said, where is your stain? Thank God, he said, the stain of death is sin. Thank God, and the strength of sin is the law. And then he began to encourage those who were waiting down here. He said unto them, therefore, brethren, be steadfast and unmovable, always abounding in the works of the Lord, because you know your labor is not in vain. In other words, it may seem like what you're doing is worthless. It may appear that no one appreciates what you're doing. But he said, don't focus on that. Focus on one fact, that your labor is not in vain. I want you to understand that God is a good timekeeper. Oh, yes, he is. He will not forget one day of your labor. And I want you to know he's faithful. Who has promised. And so Paul was encouraging them. Don't be dismayed because of rejection. Don't be dismayed because people won't receive the doctrine. Don't be dismayed and walk away with your head down. He said your labor is not in vain. In other words, there's a book that's being written by God Almighty. And every act that you perform is written in that book. And when the saints of God stand before the throne of God in the heavenly places, all of our works is going to come forth, and we're going to be judged out of the things that we have done. But listen, this is not the judgment of sinners. This is the judgment of saints. This is not the judgment for righteousness. It is the judgment of the works that you and I have done. God wants to reward you for the works that you have done. Therefore, he got a book of remembrance of all of those who trust in him. If you believe it, give God a praise and tell God thank you. The power of the resurrection is in God Almighty. And so our hope is in the resurrection. Our hope of life is in the resurrection. Our endurance is in the resurrection. If it was not so, we might as well close the Bible, shut down the piano organ, amen, close down the choir, amen, get rid of the ushers, and close down the deacon board, because all we're doing is in vain. But I thank God right now that God raised Jesus, and he raised him from the dead. And because Jesus got up, I got a written guarantee that one of these days he's coming back for me. Give God a praise and tell God thank you. One of these days he gonna call me home. I'm going where the wicked is gonna cease from troubling, and the weary is gonna get some rest. Give God a praise and tell him thank you. We're going to a place that is glorified by him. We're going to a place where the sun is not necessary, air condition is not necessary, none of those things are needed, because this place is a place that's been made comfort by God. It is a place where we don't need the sunlight, because the glory of God himself is going to be with us. If you believe it, give God a praise and tell God thank you. Somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, this is what we used to talk about, but church has outgrown the resurrection. We used to talk about leaving here, but now we are so caught up and connected to this world that we don't want to think about going home. We don't want to think about it, and we don't want anybody else talking about it. But I want to tell you today, that was the exciting time of the early church. Paul told the Thessalonians, he told them, said, don't worry about those who have fallen asleep, because we who are alive shall not prevent them. But the God I serve is going to come down from heaven with a shout in the voice of the archangel, and the dead in Christ is going to rise first, and we who are alive and remain, we're going to be caught up with them to meet the Lord in the air. And then he said, comfort one another with these words. You need to comfort somebody and say, it's not going to be like this always. Trouble is not going to last always. Trial and tribulations is not going to last always. One of these days, I'm going to have a final deliverance. One of these days, every shackle, hallelujah, is going to be broken. Every burden is going to be lifted. Give God a praise and shout hallelujah. Somebody say yeah. Anybody want to go? Anybody want to go? Anybody want to go? I want to go where Jesus is. Good God from glory. I can see it in my own mind. I can see graves opening up. And I have an illustration. The Bible declares when Jesus rose from the dead, hallelujah, that those who were dead, the graves opened up. While he was hanging on the cross, graves started opening up. Oh, bless the name of God, which was a testimony that he had gotten the victory. So the dead was in the grave, but didn't nobody get up until Jesus got up, because he's the first fruit of them that slept. Give God a praise. If he's the first fruit, then I must be the second. Give God a praise. I'm so glad that I'm in the number. Are you glad that you are part of that number? If you believe it, give God a praise and shout hallelujah. Say yeah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Yeah, he got up when he left the grave. He got up and he had all power in his hand. The Bible said he spoiled principalities and made a show of them openly, which means he took the devil in his own household and strapped him on his shoulder and went marching around in that spirit world, declaring the victory over the devil. All of his angels were standing in amazement. They didn't know what to think. Their leader had had fallen. Hell had been emptied. Give God a praise and shout hallelujah. The Bible says he led captivity captive and gave gifts unto men. Give God a praise and shout hallelujah. I'm so glad that he raised me. I'm so glad that he saved me. I thank God for Calvary. Give God a praise. Shout hallelujah. That's what he did. So Paul said, we are in big trouble.
Yes, sir.
If these things that he said don't happen, we are in a terrible fix.
Yes, Lord.
My sins remain. My guilt remain. I'm still in bondage. Hallelujah, hallelujah. But if he rose, then all these things are passed away. I'm a brand new creature. Hallelujah. And I'm looking for a new home. I already got a new owner. I'm looking for my new home. Give God a praise and tell him thank you. Because he lived, I shall live also. Give God a praise and tell the Lord thank you. They didn't recognize how powerful he is. If you take the resurrection out, then you have no life-giving book. You got to have the resurrection of Jesus Christ. In him we live, move, and have our being. So we got to understand that when he went down, we all went down with him. But when he came up, we all came up with him. And today we can shout the victory. He gave us power over the enemy and told us no weapon that's formed against us is going to hurt us. He told us we're more than a conqueror through him that loves us. Why? Because he's conquered everything. If you believe that, give God a shout today. All right, all right.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Now, I'm not a big fan of Easter. But I am a fan of the resurrection. I'm not even a fan of how they arranged it. I'm not a fan of that. But I am a fan of the resurrection. Because I know without the resurrection, I will still be in my sins. It is the resurrection that gives basics for changing our lives. If you look at the disciples, there was a change in them after Jesus rose from the dead and went back to glory. The same Peter that denied him is now one of the most powerful preachers on the planet. Amen? There was Peter that stood up on the day of Pentecost and said, no, they're not drunk like you suppose. This is that. Before that Pentecost, amen, in the death, burial, and resurrection, Peter probably would have been running. But now he said, uh-uh. And listen, that which God has put in him is so powerful. Thank God, and I said this some time ago, that it amplified his voice so that over 3,000 folk heard him. He didn't have a microphone like I got. 3,000 were baptized when they heard about the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. They grabbed a hold of it. The next time we read, 5,000 got a hold of it. The death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. Amen. He is the life giver. He's the only one that has power to give life. He's the only one that can redeem us from sin. He's the only one that can raise us from the dead. And he's just not talking about raising us from a physical graveyard like behind the church out there. He's already raised us once. Because all of us was dead in trespasses and sin. But the Bible said, but God. But God, who is rich in mercy. But God, while we were yet sinners, Christ died. What a privilege it is to give glory to him. Hallelujah. Those who had counted us out, we came from the back right to the front. We stopped being second-class citizens and became first-class. The believer's not riding coach anymore. You got a place in the first-class section. You understand that? Amen. So he wants us to expect him to come, but in the meantime, he wants you to live like first-class citizens.
Bless you, Father.
Yes. Paul said, I know, Job brother said, I know that my Redeemer lives.
All right.
And I know that at the latter days, he shall stand up on the earth. And though my skin worm has destroyed this body, yet in my flesh shall I see God. He looked down through time and saw the resurrection. He saw Jesus getting up. Paul says, I know in whom I have believed, and that he's able to keep that which I have committed unto him against that day. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The power in the resurrection. Hallelujah. If you're here today, thank you, Lord. If you're here on today and you do not know the Lord Jesus Christ, amen. Think of maybe somebody told you he died, but I'm here to tell you he got up. He got up. Amen. He got up. He said, in 3 days, I'll raise this temple up. In 3 days, he raised it up. Yes, he did. He raised it up in 3 days. Amen. He said, I'll raise it up. He raised it up. Thank God. The first day of the week. Amen. Thank God. Amen. It changed the order in which believers hold services. Thank God. Because of the resurrection. Because of the resurrection, amen, we get the first day of the week, what we call Sunday. Amen. Thank God. We call it Sunday. Amen. Thank God. And so we changed the church. Amen. Began to worship on Sunday morning.